Hello, my students. Look where we are today. Yes, of course, it's a classic Italian pizzeria. I know you're waiting for it, and here we are, because we are Italians and we have to speak about pizza. By the way, do you like it or not? And which one is your favorite pizza? Margherita, quattro formaggi, capricciosa? Comment to this video and tell me more, which is the most original pizza you tried. As Italians, we are really proud to be the inventors of the modern pizza. However, its origin can be traced far back in the past. The pizza's ancestor was born in the ancient Greeks that covered the bread with oils, herbs, and cheese. Modern pizza originated in Italy as the Napoleon pie with tomato. In 1889, cheese was added by Ferdinando I, King of Naples and the two Sicilies. In 1889, during a visit in Naples, Queen Margherita of Savoy was served a pizza resembling the colors of the Italian flag: red for tomato, white for mozzarella, and green for basil. The kind of pizza has been named after the queen as Pizza Margherita. Quite a lot of history, huh? So next time you bite into a slice of pizza, be respectful. So guys, now it's time to be serious. Adesso parliamo in italiano. What do you think? We study the present of the verb to be and to have. Let's go on with the regular verb.
Ciao Jessica, come stai?
Bene Giovanni, e tu?
Così così, devo fare delle cose che odio.
Cosa devi fare?
Devo pagare le bollette, buttare la spazzatura, andare dal dottore e studiare fisica quantistica.
E cosa ti piace fare?
Io amo leggere libri, andare a cavallo, studiare filosofia.
Hey, did you understand the dialogue? No, don't worry, it's because it's full of verbs. Let's try to understand a bit more of the Italian verbs, starting by the easiest form, the infinite. In English, the infinite, l'infinito, consists of to plus the verb. To sleep, to drink, to eat. In Italian, the infinite is composed of just one word, dormire, bere, mangiare. All Italian verbs fall into one of the three groups, conjugations, according to their infinite form that can either end in are, ere, ire. Within each category, there are regular and irregular verbs. So in the first group, we will have verbs as andare, to go, odiare, to hate. In the second, correre, to run, leggere, to read. And in the third, dormire, to sleep, ferire, to hurt. As you have noticed, all the verbs are made up of a body, parl, and a suffix, are, ere, ire. The three infinite form are really important because the other tense of the verbs will be conjugated according to the group they belong to. We will see it in detail within the next lesson. Let's watch again the dialogue and let's try to see the infinite verbs.
Ciao Jessica, come stai?
Bene Giovanni, e tu?
Così così, devo fare delle cose che odio.
Cosa devi fare?
Devo pagare le bollette, buttare la spazzatura, andare dal dottore e studiare fisica quantistica.
E cosa ti piace fare?
Io amo leggere libri, andare a cavallo, studiare filosofia.
Did you recognize them? Very well. Giovanni must pagare le bollette, buttare la spazzatura, andare dal dottore e studiare fisica. All infinite verbs. Also, Giovanni likes andare a cavallo, studiare filosofia. So I think for today it's enough. Study the infinite and memorize the meanings of the verbs. Soon you will be able to create your sentences. You can also read the corresponding written lesson on your website, girlsforteaching.com. Alla prossima lezione! Ciao ciao!